Ask me what I'm mixed with. I told him half black and I'm half savage, bitch. Walk in your trap and take over. Name another bitch that's colder. I just bought a brand new Rover. I don't even drive no more, I got a chauffeur. Took off, man, they asking me to slow up. Getting wiser and my money getting older.
What's up, y'all? It's your girl, Sayor, and I'm back with another video. Excuse my voice. I just woke up. I honestly don't even have the energy to just yell or nothing like that. But, as you see by the title, today is going to be, don't mind my lashes. But today is going to be a day in my life as a nail tech. Today I have two clients. I have my 9:30 client that just came that I am about to do. And I have a 12 p.m. client. So hopefully we could probably get some walk-ins later. If not, that's fine. I'm very grateful. But I've been trying to do this vlog for the longest. Y'all don't understand. And every time I try to do it, one of my clients don't show up. There are no call, no show. So fingers crossed, if you see this vlog, that means everybody came. And we did what we had to do today. So I already set up yesterday, sanitized, disinfected everything last night. Just to save me some time. I don't have enough time, honestly. This is probably gonna be a montage of the nails, cause you know I don't have no storage on my phone. But I'm gonna get this video out for you guys. So I'm still in my robe. I need to get dressed and get active, cause I don't have that much time and my client's at 12, and plus I am doing a crazy set right now. So let's get into it. All right, y'all, so I'm editing this video, but I'm going to go ahead and add a clip of a nail set that I previously did that I love, and I'm not gonna let no footage go to waste. So that is going to be my previous client, but then we just gonna zoom back into my current client today.
Birthday, but some last night is. Average day to go and have a right little list. I'm struggling on toe like a bite in a straw. I fly across the globe, but I call none of it. It wasn't because they know how sloppy you can get. I'm running to the top, but I'm bottom of the bitch. You can't rub a burn, and he running out of hits. Say the wrong word, I'ma shoot him in the shit. This a big dog, you a poodle, I'ma pick. I'm touching all the dogs, that's as far as I can spit. Just walking out the mall, and you like it, then you get it. You standing by the tile, and you broken with a piss.
So I just finished my second client today. I look a mess. She's over there geeked up. I'm not gonna I will put it in the clip. But yeah, I just finished my second client. I am about to clean up and probably just get some food and really chill out. Check my site, just do my daily nail checkup checklist. So my client is finally gone. Usually when I'm done with a client, I'd be damn near exhausted. As you can see, the mat is still pretty clean, but I'm still gonna throw it away just because somebody already utilized it. And I kind of pretty much just sanitized from here. I have to throw away my trash because my trash got so much nail stuff in there. Oh my God, so embarrassed. Anyway, I'm gonna organize these, all of which I'm not gonna do on camera. Now, I do have like a nail checklist that I made, just to kind of keep track. Let me show you. I checked my pre-appointment checklist, cause I kind of just write it on here. And it's pre-appointment checklist, sanitize and disinfect client and workspace. Client chair, we want to sanitize the client chair, the table, everything, sterilize utensils and package them again. That means take out anything that's inside my barber side over there, clean them and package them for the next person. Broom my room, of course, of which I ain't do yet. Remove any old acrylic stuck to the table. It doesn't look like any acrylic stuck to the table, and usually sometimes acrylic gets stuck to my table. Fix up room, of course. That means just kind of fix everything up again. Refill nail bottles. So that means I gotta refill my monomer bottle, my acetone, my alcohol, and then sanitize dust brushes that is my nail brushes. Pre-setup space for client again. So it's kind of like a routine. What I do, I have two nail desk brushes. Hold on. I have two nail dust brushes. This one, I want it too close. This one is for my nail, my client's nails. This one is to dust off the table. I know the difference because they look obviously very different. And what I do, I kind of just spray them down with alcohol, let them sit, just to kind of do that. It's not much, but definitely take precaution into certain stuff. And then I always kind of clean my drill bits. That's something I gotta add to my list. I always take this pink brush drill bit and I kind of go through all of my drill bits and clean it. These are all of my drill bits, as you guys can see. And then I do gotta fill up these. I'm running out of monomer. I don't even have monomer to fill this up. I have to buy another one. That's my problem. I only buy, I think a 16-ounce bottle of monomer, and then that kind of lasts me, but now I'm running out. I fill up my acetone, and then this is kind of my alcohol spray bottle that I use. And yeah, so what I do, I just kind of take this off, wipe it down. Sometime if I need to, I will flip it. Just because, spray it down with disinfectant spray or alcohol, and then I come around here with my barbicides. These been sitting here about at least like 20 minutes, so it's time to take these out. And then I kind of sanitize them and repackage them. So that's what I'm about to do. Today been a good day so far. I really hope I can get some walk-ins in. That would definitely be really nice if I can get some walk-ins today. I had two clients. I'm very grateful. I'm very blessed to be able to have two clients. Yeah, it's a good feeling. I've came a long way doing nails. Every day, you know, obviously every day is a new day. You kind of just gotta stay positive and don't let no shows, no calls throw you off or, you know, make you feel like discouraged or anything. How I see it, like I was telling my client just now, I told her, every time I have a client that doesn't show up or they don't come, I take it as a sign, as if like they weren't meant to be. I didn't use this, so I'm gonna package this because I actually end up using this one I have here. And yeah, so this is kind of what I do after every client. I make sure that I set up a routine checklist for my clients. And just for the workspace alone, I like to get a routine because I feel like this is my life now, that I'm pursuing to be a nail tech. And even when I'm not doing clients, or after I'm not, even if when I'm not doing clients, even if I am doing clients, I still have to just walk in that. Walk as a nail tech, act like a nail tech, be a nail tech, because I am a nail tech. So, you know, I was going to just set up. You see how I set that up like that? Boom. Okay. And then, I love to kind of get into the this, go inside and wipe it down with some alcohol wipes, disinfectant wipes, whatever works for you. You gotta know, every day is a new client. So let me go ahead and sanitize these. But right now I'm just going through my routine that I do. I hate when that happens. I pretty much just put this and I just got it wet. Yeah. And now all I do is repackage them after they've been sterilized. Just like this. And I go in with the buffer. And then I seal it up. Now me, what I do, I like to put the date on it so I know when I did it, because I don't like to have them sitting in there. Even though dust is not touching them, I just don't like to have them, the sterilized ones, sitting there too long. Because I feel like if they sit there too long, it's not as effective. Today is the 23rd. And just like that. So since I have two clients, of course, I only have two sets to sterilize. But obviously, on a day that I would have had more clients, I would just kind of just do the whole nine yard. So right now, all I'm doing is just refilling my alcohol. I use 91% alcohol because I feel like that's just more effective for me. And you can't go wrong with alcohol. Now I'm going to fill up my acetone bottle. This is the acetone I use. You can find this at Savvy's. You can find this at the nail store. You can find this at Walgreens. You can find this at Family Dollar, Dollar General. Whatever you have next to you. I'm about to go throw the garbage out. My little dollar. My little diffuser. I could turn that off now. My client is gone. And my phone's about to die. But y'all, today was a chilled day. Also, another thing I'm gonna do. Let me check my site before I close out this video. Let me check it. Before I close out this video, I need to check. Today was a good day, though. Let me refresh and see if I got anybody. Okay. A little encouragement. I really want to show you guys something. For this month, I have 7 clients. Mind you, I've just started. It's been a couple months now that I've been doing nails. Maybe like 3 months, 2 or 3 months thus far I've been doing nails. So this is really amazing to me. I've had more people, but I canceled their appointment because no show. So obviously it's not going to pop up here, and I don't count that because if they didn't show up to their appointment, then they don't count. So today's the 23rd. I had one client that I did. Kudos to her for showing up. Super, super sweet girl. Super nice. And, you know, hopefully to see her back again. I have another client way next week. So that gave me a couple of days to just kind of prep. Hopefully I can get some walk-ins and whatever the case may be. And then on this day, I have 2 appointments back-to-back. Like today was a back-to-back. Today I had a squeezing at 9 a.m. and then I also had my original client at 12. Now, last month, as you guys could see, I had no clients scheduled. Majority of the clients that I had for that month were walk-ins or squeeze-ins, and it wasn't really much. It's probably like 2-3 people out of that month. And that's just being honest with you guys. The month before that, August, I only originally had 2 clients. Mind you, let me show y'all why I say that. Because when you click on them, it says you will not be paying for this appointment. This is the month I started, which was August. It tells you you will not be paying for this appointment. You will not be paying for this appointment. That meaning that they were models that I recruited to do their nails, to be able to kind of just give my page something to show people so that people can book. And, you know, this was an actual client. This was an actual client, and this was an actual client. So for this month, I had 3 original clients. Moving on to the next month, I didn't have any clients scheduled. But of course, I think, if I'm not mistaken, I probably had like 2 people. Or if it's not 2 people, probably my friend came to me like twice or whatnot in that month to get her nails done. You know, originally, that don't count. Although she paid, doesn't count because it's not really a client. But, you know, at the end of the day, a client is a client, period. And this month, I am so grateful to see 7 clients for the month. Mind y'all, I do work a full-time job. So 7 clients for the month is really good. And I just hope to see how next month's look. And I just hope next month I could probably have at least like 15 clients for the month. So just speaking things into existence. Right now, y'all might just smoke me a blunt and just do what I have to do. So this is a part of my daily nail checkup, to check my website to see if anybody booked, because sometimes people book, they don't send a deposit, and then I have to kind of get in contact with them and let them know, hey, I'm about to cancel the appointment due to no deposit. On my page, it states that no deposit equals no appointment. Now, what I wanted to say, and I'm going to show y'all how my website looked, because a lot of you guys probably don't follow me on Instagram or probably don't follow my page. So I'm going to show you how my scheduling look, and I just really want people to really look over that. But one thing I wanted to say before I do close out this vlog is that stay consistent, stay positive, pray. I always pray over all my clients before they come, after they leave, even when they actually book. Like, I always just pray. I think that's super important, to just kind of bless the energy that's about to come and bless the energy once they leave. And, you know, thus far, I haven't had any weird encounters with people. So I kind of really want to keep it that way. Not even kind of, I want to keep it that way. I don't want any weird encounters. People don't want to pay or anything of that sort. And I just don't want to speak it to existence. But, you know, that's that. And I want to say, if you are a beginner nail tech, yes, you. If you are a beginner nail tech and you're obviously watching this video for a reason, you're probably into nails, you're probably a beginner, you've probably been doing nails, you probably like the thumbnail, whatever reason that you're watching this video, I want y'all to know, for my beginners or for my nail techs, or even if you're not a beginner and you're still having problems getting clients, I want you guys to know that it's okay once in a while to recruit some models, whether one or two, even if they're not paying. I never look at it as wasting product or anything, because I look at it as it's an investment. And I honestly love to do nails, and it's never about the money for me. And when it comes to that, I can do nails for 5 hours and be at peace. So, you know, never feel like y'all stressing me when the time's running, because I'm doing just fine. I mean, I love what I do, and I take pride in what I do, and I just want y'all to know it's okay to take models here and there. Sometimes you gotta put in that work, man. You can't just sit there and expect people to come and wait for people to book. If they ain't seeing no work, they don't want to book, because that's how I am, and I'm gonna be real. If I don't see a certain style that I would potentially get off of the page, then I don't know for sure you know how to do it, I might just look at someone else, or I might prefer someone else because they have it. And I know it's just like, if you're going to get some bohemian braids from somebody, if you see someone post the bohemian braids and they actually did it good versus somebody that say they know how to do it but ain't never did it, who would you go with? You answer that. Comment down below who you would went to. But that's just real shit. And, you know, if you got some styles you save or some freestyles in mind, go ahead and recruit people that you know that's willing to support you and doesn't mind getting their nails done. Who doesn't like a free nail set? And, you know, eventually, you won't have to do that anymore. You will be fully booked. You would have consistent clients. You will have new clients. You will be blessed. Like, trust me, y'all. Stay consistent. Keep going. I'm very grateful for the progress that I have done thus far, and I'm proud of myself. Give me a pat on the back, because I've been doing really good. And, you know, when it comes to nails, I'm always on top of what I need to be on top of. And if you guys like more of this video, just let me know, because I'm definitely willing to post more videos like this if my clients show up. But no shade to anybody. Love y'all. And let me just show y'all my site before I go. This is my website. Say Your Nailed It. Y'all know, follow me on Instagram so you can keep up with your girl in every post that I have. I am located in Miami. If you want to be more precise, I am located in North Miami, Florida. So this is my little introduction. Thank you for choosing me as your nail tech. I highly appreciate and can't wait for you to get nailed. Please carefully read my policy below prior to booking an appointment. That's real shit, because people don't read, they don't read. And then, of course, my general information. This is what I need people to read, because they don't read. It tells you, obviously, in a case of a cancellation, please let me know, cancel it ahead of time. And I don't know if there's something wrong with my site, but my client just now said she didn't even get a confirmation, like a reconfirmation, letting her know she had an appointment. So that's scary, because I gotta check on that, because I don't know what's going on, and I don't know why it's not doing that. But anyway, to go back. General information deposit. I only require a $10 deposit, which goes towards your appointment. I think starting January, I am going to be taking a deposit, but the deposit will no longer go to the appointment because some people be canceling and it just be too much. And then obviously it says I'm home based, so no extra guests. COVID purposes, please wear your mask. If you don't feel good, stay your ass home. And additional information, it just say, you know, come with your nails clean, bare. I don't work over other people's nails, and book accordingly because time can change. Now, I just have this cute little quote from Albert Einstein that says, creativity is intelligence having fun. And if you think about it, that's real shit, because creativity is intelligent having fun. Creativity is pretty much you playing wild with your mind and your imagination. So I think that's super, super dope. And it just says, book your appointment. And then, of course, I have my short full sets. These are the prices in case you guys are wondering to book. Mediums, long, and that's what I offer. Once again, y'all, it's your girl Sayor. You like my natural nails? Look at these, super cute. I did them myself. I had some Halloween inspo nails. I might put a clip in there to show y'all, but I had it for like 3 days and I end up getting old of it, and I hate getting old of sets that I have. But I just decided to do some natural nails because they get messed up with my clients, but I need my nails done, because how you a nail tech and your nails not done and you doing somebody else's nails? That's scary. But it be like that though, but still. Anyways. So I just want to say thank you for watching. You guys, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and join the crew. If you know it's your girl, say yours, say your nail, say your slim, whatever you want to call it. So stay tuned until the next video. Comment down below what kind of videos you would like to see. And for those that miss me, miss y'all too. Your girl is back somewhat, kind of like that. But yeah, until next time. This is Bloopers, but I wanted to show y'all one of my pups. This is Simba. He's a terrier mixed with a pit bull. Look at him. He's so fat, y'all. All he do is eat. Look. He's so fat. Say bye, guys. Say bye, Papo. Later. Tell him later. Okay, we about to go because he's hungry. He probably wants to eat, and he's looking at me like, Mom, why you got me up like that? But later, y'all. Bye.